Hey, BeerTubers, Ryan here with a best of 2013, and we'll talk about what's going to happen and hopefully what I'm looking forward to in 2014. So, first off, everyone, I am drinking out of my new glass, brought back to the U.S. straight from London is my new BrewDog glass, and I'm drinking some Highland Park 15-year-old scotch. Yes, I know, it's San Diego Beer Blog, but yes, I do enjoy a good single malt. First, we're going to do my list of, it turned out to be 16 beers. I just picked out, I was going to whittle it down to 10. I thought, you know what, bunch of nonsense, let's just list them off. I'll do a brief description of each and call it a day. So, starting with January 1st of 2013, I reviewed Canteon Creek. It's the 100% Bio Creek, same thing. Over here, it's just like 100% Creek. Anyway, phenomenal beer. It's Canteon. Can't really go wrong with 99.5% of Canteon out there. So, phenomenal beer. Wish I could buy it more often here, but can't. Nailsmith BA Speedway Stout. Reviewed that one with my buddy Daniel. That made that review even more special. So, Nailsmith actually released two versions of Barrel Age Speedway. Or I shouldn't say two versions. Two batches of Speedway Stout in 2013, so that was very cool. A favorite of mine was Cigar City's White Oak High Life. Not a huge fan of the regular High Life, but the White Oak version was really, really cool. Added a ton of vanilla to it and made the beer taste like an orange creamsicle IPA. And I was a big fan of that, and I guess it just recently came out in cans. Another huge favorite was Alesmith Decadence 2012. I didn't get to that until 2013. It's in a Belgian-style quadruple. It is by far and away the best American quadruple that I've ever had. And, in fact, I will take that over several of the well-known Belgian versions of the style, including, like, Chimay Blue, for sure. It's awesome beer. I also reviewed Goose Island's Bourbon County Brand Stout in the 2012 batch, but I did it in 2013. They've been on fire with that beer the last 3 years. Highly recommend that. Everyone raves about it. It's worth seeking out if you can't get it. But thankfully, I can get it here these days, which is cool. Black Friday, Goose Island finally brought that beer back to California. Another favorite was, I believe it was Batch 10 of Epic's Big Bad Baptist. I believe they're on Batch 13 right now. I have not had 13, but 10 was fantastic. Nice complexity to it. Another favorite, and I know I'm probably in the minority when it comes to smoked beers, but I really love the brewery's collaboration with Beechwood Brewing, the Mrs. Stoutfire Stout. I thought it was a great collaboration. It was just a big, thick stout. It reminded me of like a Cigar City Marshall Zukas, but it had that smoke characteristic from the Beechwood smoked malt that they used in there. And it was a combination of like three different woods that Beechwood also uses for their barbecue. And I was a big fan of that beer. One of my maybe top three, five beers of the year is actually Firestone Walker's Peebo Pils. I know a lot of people rave about their barrel-aged stuff. I love Peebo Pils. It's a beer that I can session. I can go through a six-pack in the night if I really wanted to. I think it's a fantastic Pilsner, American take on a German-style Pilsner. And it's such a drinkable beer. It's got some nice hoppiness to it, just fantastic. Another good one was the Hair of the Dog Fred from the Wood, not the Bourbon Fred from the Wood. That was pretty much completely flat but delicious, but the Fred from the Wood was properly carbonated and still had a lot of really nice complexity to it, and it'll age really well, so love that one. Another beer from Alesmith was their Old Ale. This was originally released as Decadence 2005. They brought it back for Decadence 2010. And then now it's going to be a seasonal beer, and that started in 2013, and I bought a bunch of balls to age, and I'm looking forward to picking up more for an eventual vertical down the road. A fantastic hoppy beer that I liked from the Midwest was Fathead's Headhunter. I had had that previously on draft at GABF in 2012, and finally got a bottle of that to review. I forget who I got that from. It might have been my buddy Joel, or maybe I got it through a trade. I can't remember. One of my probably breweries of the year is probably Crooked Stave out of Denver, Colorado. Fantastic, funky, farmhouse, saisons, those type of beers. And my favorite from them is Surette. Well, I mean, at least the regular lineup stuff is Surrette. It's fantastic. Recommended if you like. It's got sort of that tartness you get in the sour ale, but it's, I don't know. It's just got great complexity, really easy drinking stuff. Love it. One of my biggest surprises was Stone Southern Chard. Stone's been doing the barrel program for a while, but they seem to be sort of, I don't want to say they're half-assing it, but they didn't really know what they're doing, to be honest, from what I gathered. Until they brought in Steve Gonzalez to run their barrel program. And I believe this is one of the first beers that Steve's done. I could be wrong in that. My information could be wrong. The Southern Chard is a fantastic blend of different barrels and different barrels at different with the beer at different age points. One's second use, one's brand new. Southern Char was fantastic. I love that beer. It's highly recommended by me. Another one that blew me away, definitely in my, say, top five of the year, was Boulevard's Bourbon Barrel Quad, the fresh batch of that. I'd had an aged bottle of that. I love the thing fresh. I bought a second bottle. I might just drink that one pretty soon and maybe not age it. I don't know. It was so good fresh. It's kind of hard to age a beer when it's that good fresh. Finally got to try this next beer, Evil Twins Even More Jesus. That beer, I believe, started maybe mid to late 2002. Evil Twin, I think, brewed it maybe overseas, and they finally brewed a batch, I believe, at Westbrook on the East Coast in the U.S., and I thought the beer lived up to the hype that I was getting from watching the reviews from a lot of you beer reviewers over in Europe. And lastly was Hill Farmstead's Civil Disobedience number 7. That was my 500th beer review, and I picked a fantastic beer for a 500th review. That beer is a blend of a barrel-aged Saison from Hill Farmstead, blended with, I believe it was 2-year-old Cantillon Lambic, and was such a fantastic blend. You got the Cantillon funkiness, you got the nice barrel-aged wine character coming from the Hill Farmstead beer, and it was a great blend. And great beer to celebrate 500 beer reviews, which is something I hit in 2013. So thanks to everyone out there who's been around a long time, or even if you recently tuned in, appreciate the views, appreciate the comments. I try to respond to everyone in the comments on my videos. So please leave comments. For 2014, moving forward to 2014, I want to do maybe a little less beer reviews. I do have a bunch that I shot in 2013 because I had a bunch of time off from work at the end of the year that kind of backlogged. So I'll space those out, but I'd like to do a little bit more homebrew stuff. Unfortunately, sometimes when I get homebrewing, I just get into brewing so much that I kind of forget to take the camera out and actually film some footage. So I've missed probably 3 or 4 sessions where I might have had a unique, not a unique idea, but just an idea to pass along that I'm trying out that some of you may not have heard of that could be something that you'd want to do in the future, and just like passing on knowledge that I get from reading and learning from my fellow homebrewers, a lot of my friends, people in the homebrew clubs I meet up with. You know, the stuff I do is not necessarily the most original. It's just me kind of taking in as much information as I can and then taking that to how I like to brew beer or how I can currently brew beer on my system. I'd love to have a fancy automated system with pit controllers and all that stuff, but I have the most manual brewing system out there, and I don't really have the money to spend on the really, really fancy stuff, so I'm just going to keep doing more or less the way I'm doing it now. New to 2013 is I finally bought a March pump to homebrew so I can whirlpool. That does two things for me. It allows me to add hops at flame out and get a nice whirlpool and get them mixed into the wort after flame out. And two, it helps me cool down a lot faster with an immersion chiller. I've noticed my times are cut maybe in half from previous times where I just let it sit and occasionally stir, and it cools so much faster just whirlpooling with immersion chiller, especially when the groundwater is cool. We have really warm groundwater here in San Diego for the most of the year. Even in the wintertime, I still need to use an ice bath to pump through my wort chiller to help cool down, although I need less ice this time of the year. So, homebrewing wise, it was a really good 2013. I don't know if it would be tops. Robert and I, we started working on the R&R Cookin' IPA, I believe, November, December of 2012, and brewed, well, probably two batches each in early 2013 to get ready for the Stone AHA rally. And that kind of took a lot of my time and effort in the early part of 2012. And I didn't get to do as many different batches of beer. But it was very cool, very exciting to win that competition. It was a lot of fun to go through the process of doing all that. And learned a lot. And thanks to everyone for reviewing the beer on YouTube. I have to say, I believe, unofficially, that's the Stone version is the most reviewed beer on YouTube. If you do a Google or a YouTube search, it's like at least two pages of review. So thanks to everyone that took their time to review that beer. And I got lucky in competitions. I started in 2012 when I did the barrel aged quadruple and took it to the homebrew club, and people really enjoyed it and told me I should enter into the quaff strong ale competition, and I won the wood age category. So since then I've been picking and choosing my categories, and I have a nice streak going. My beer has either won the overall competition, or it's at least won its category. In the Encinitas Brew Fest, I got first in stout, second runner-up, best of show. And then Mother Earth had a festival / homebrew competition. My IPA won first in IPA and got second runner-up, best in show. So fortunately, I had two best of show. And then in December, I entered the Modern Times homebrew competition. It's a new brewery. You might know them through a lot of the social media stuff they've been doing. They got Mike, the Mad Fermentationist, a well-known homebrewer, to help out with their recipe development and help out their sour program and get it kick-started. And they do a monthly homebrew competition that I think might eventually lead to a pro-am beer out of it. I don't know how it's going to work, but eventually sometime here in 2014, I'll be brewing on their pilot system, and I haven't scheduled that yet, but looking forward to doing that. So that's something to look forward to in 2014. I'm trying to do some more brewing to style type of beers to help out quaff with the National Homebrewers Conference. So I'm going to try to do some stuff I either haven't brewed in a while, like I just did a dry Irish stout. I haven't brewed one since the extract days. So I did one of those, and I have a list of other beers I'd like to do. Robust Porter. I've done a porter before. It's been since the extract days. I haven't done a sweet stout. I've done an oatmeal stout, but that was a long time ago. I want to rebrew the Russian Imperial Stout that I won the Modern Times homebrew competition up and got second best of show at the Encinitas Brew Fest. I've never brewed an English IPA. I'd like to try it. Of course, I'll be brewing up American and Imperial IPAs. I'd love to do a Roggen beer, which is, think Hefeweizen, but instead of using all that wheat malt, you use rye malt. You're still using the German Hefe yeast to get that banana clove characteristics. I've been trying to dial in a better Saison recipe, and I got pretty close in 2013 with kind of how I want it. And that's thanks to the White Labs, the Belgian Saison 3 yeast. Really liked how that strain performed. I think I want to take that and maybe blend it with another strain. I'd like to rebrew my Belgian quad, and based on how that turns out, I'll either throw it back into the Virgin American Oak Barrel like I did the first time around, or I'll just keep it as is. And I'd like to go back to brewing another smoke beer, particularly my Scotch Ale I did with the peat smoked malt and aged on, I believe it was American Oak that had been soaking in Isla single malt Scotch whiskey. And I'd like to rebrew that beer, or maybe do a different type of smoked beer. Since, like I mentioned, I am probably in the minority when it comes to liking smoked beers for at least a lot of my friends and people I know. So, all right, guys, that's going to wrap up 2013 year in review. My favorite beers that I reviewed on YouTube. I had a lot of fantastic bottle shares. I'd say 2013 was the year of bottle shares for me. I had probably averaged at least two a month, and it put a little bit of a dent in my collection, but I like to put more of a dent in my beer collection in the future, because as you saw, I posted my what I called my beer cellar videos on the beers that I have aging, and had a lot of fantastic beers with some great friends in 2013, and it's already continued in 2014, so I'm looking forward to more of that this year. And thanks for watching, everyone. This video has gone on far too long. Till next time, cheers.